Hi guys, it's me, Hala, and for today's topic, we're going to be talking about air quality in my local environment. So let's move on. Let's start off by defining what is air. So, what's air? I'm sure everyone watching this knows what air is, but for those who don't, I don't think so. Air is the mixture of invisible gases that surrounds the earth, and it contains important substances such as oxygen and nitrogen. And these substances are important to most species because they use it to survive. We are an example to those species. Our bodies ask for oxygen, and oxygen comes from air. So, that's air. Why is air important? As I said, it's important for most species because they use it to survive. So, for us humans and other living things, breathing is a part of a process called respiration. During respiration, a living thing takes in oxygen from the air and gives out carbon dioxide. This process gives animals and plants the energy to eat, grow, and live life. Knowing the importance of air, with no air, there is no life. Every living thing needs air. Try holding your breath for 30 seconds and tell me what happens then. You need oxygen, you need air. You take oxygen from air. So by that, air quality is important. What's air quality? Air quality is a measure of how clean and pure and how polluted the air is. And of course, we need the cleanest and purest air to breathe in. So the more polluted the air is, the more the danger goes to every living thing surrounding that air, that toxic air. And one of the biggest challenges the environment is facing is the exposure of the atmosphere to chemicals, physical particles, and biological compounds that causes damages to the environment and living things. And this is called air pollution. It affects cities, forests, and ecosystems. It also affects humans, as it is in the fourth stage of threats to its health. So based on the figures of the World Health Organization, there are about 4 million premature deaths resulting from air pollution. And it is also the cause for many respiratory diseases. For my local environment, I live in Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia. Based on this danger resulting from air pollutants, to ensure control over them and to take appropriate decisions to reduce the negative effects of these pollutants, the Royal Commission of Riyadh City launched the Air Quality Management Program, whose various ways ensure the quality of the city's air. By monitoring air quality inside neighborhoods, on roads, and outside urban areas. To reduce the effects of pollutant sources, which helps in maintaining the health of the residents of the city of Riyadh. The Royal Commission for Riyadh City also has taken steps, and these steps are to contribute the air quality within the city. And among those steps, one of these steps are the King Abdulaziz Public Transportation Project, which seeks to reduce the use of cars to approximately 47%, which reduces the percentage of pollutants emitted from vehicles. Another one of those steps is launching the Green Riyadh Project, which contributes to improving air quality by the trees' work of reducing dust and absorbing harmful gases in the air. Also, launching an application and a website to display air quality indicators in the area surrounding the user in real time. They also provide data that will support research and scientific studies on the state of air quality. And there are other countries as well improving the air quality, as it is very important for us to breathe in the cleanest and purest air for us to take in. At the end of the day, stay safe, stay away from polluted areas, try to surround yourself with the cleanest air possible, because it's your health and it's your body and you need to take care of it. I'm Hala, and thanks for watching.